The drama surrounding Diddy just keeps getting messier. 50 Cent has now dragged Jennifer Lopez into the scandal, accusing her of allegedly participating in freak-offs with minors at Diddy's infamous parties. And if you know anything about 50 Cent, he doesn't just throw accusations around without backing them up. This time, he's coming hard for Diddy and even implicating J.Lo in some seriously shady activities. For years, people thought J.Lo's only involvement with Diddy was linked to that infamous 1999 nightclub shooting, where rapper Shine took the fall. But according to 50, there's much more to the story. In fact, he claims J.Lo may have kept up her association with Diddy's questionable antics long after they broke up. And here's the real bombshell. 50 is also saying that Ben Affleck knew about all of this, which might explain why he distanced himself from J.Lo before things hit the fan. So what did Ben know? And was Diddy really holding footage of J.Lo's interactions with young boys as blackmail? According to 50, he's got all the answers, and what he's revealing will have you questioning everything. Let's rewind for a second. We all know J.Lo has a history with Diddy. The two dated in the late 90s, and there were always whispers about how deep their relationship went. Many saw J.Lo as Diddy's ride or die back then, almost like a Bonnie to his Clyde. But while we all knew they were a couple, it turns out J.Lo may have been involved in more than just a romance. The streets have been buzzing for years, hinting that J.Lo has always had something to hide, especially when it comes to that infamous 1999 shooting. Here's what went down that night. Diddy and J.Lo were partying at a club in Times Square, celebrating the upcoming album release of Shine, Diddy's young protege. While leaving the club, Diddy, holding a champagne bottle, accidentally bumped into a street figure named Matthew Scar Allen. Scar wasn't happy and shoved Diddy, escalating things. One of Scar's crew members threw a stack of money in Diddy's face like it was confetti.
It was the first time I was with someone who wasn't faithful. I was in the relationship with Puff where I was totally crying, crazy, and going nuts. I really took my whole life in a
Next thing you know, Diddy pulls out a gun and shots are fired. In the chaos, three people were injured, including one woman who was allegedly shot in the face by Diddy. Diddy and J.Lo didn't stick around to see the aftermath. They quickly jumped into a Lincoln Navigator with the gun stashed in the trunk and sped off. But their getaway was short-lived. They got pulled over for running a red light, not because of the shooting. Both Diddy and J.Lo were arrested, with J.Lo reportedly crying her eyes out at the police station. She was even handcuffed to a pole at one point. Her mother showed up and scolded her in Spanish, saying, "I told you to stay away from that man." It turns out Mama Lopez was right. Diddy was nothing but trouble for J.Lo. And get this, J.Lo allowed Diddy and his legal team to use her star power to help him get out of the gun charges. One of Diddy's lawyers even tried to sway the judge by saying, "I don't know if you know this, but Jennifer Lopez is a very famous actress."
The defendant engaged in a persistent and pervasive pattern of toward women and other individuals. This was at times verbal, emotional, physical, and as part of his pattern of Combs manipulated women to participate in highly orchestrated performances of activity with male commercial workers. At times, Combs and others acting at his direction made arrangements for women and commercial workers to fly to Combs' location. Combs ensured participation from the women by, among other things, obtaining and distributing to them, controlling their careers, leveraging his financial support, and to cut off the same and using intimidation and violence. It also said the defendant used the Combs business, including certain employees, to carry out, facilitate, and cover up his and commercials. Those employees, including security staff, household staff, personal assistants, and high-ranking supervisors and other close associates, acted as Combs' intermediaries, and their conduct was facilitated and assisted by Combs' control of the Combs business.
The defense worked. Diddy got off scot-free. But that's not where J.Lo's involvement in Diddy's drama ends. According to a lawsuit filed by Little Rod, a former associate, Diddy told him that it was actually J.Lo who carried the gun into the club that night and handed it to him when things went south with Scar. So was J.Lo more involved than she let on? It sure looks like it. And according to 50 Cent, J.Lo's connection to Diddy's darker side didn't stop there. He claims that even after J.Lo and Diddy broke up, she continued to be involved in his notorious freak-off parties, where young boys were allegedly brought in for disturbing activities. Even when J.Lo moved on and got married to other men, 50 says she was still connected to Diddy and these wild parties. In the recently released indictment documents, the feds describe a pattern of abuse, manipulation, and coercion by Diddy, targeting women and other individuals. The documents detail how Diddy allegedly arranged for women and male commercial workers to be flown to his location to take part in these freak-offs. These events, orchestrated by Diddy and his associates, were often extended and involved multiple commercial workers, with controlled substances used to keep everyone compliant.
Combs and other members and the associates of the Combs enterprise wielded the power and the prestige of Combs' role at the Combs business to intimidate and lure females into Combs' orbit, often under the pretense of a romantic relationship. Combs then used force, a force and coercion to cause to engage in extended acts with male commercial workers that Combs referred to as, among other things, freak-offs. It continued. Freak-offs occurred regularly, sometimes lasted multiple days, and often involved multiple commercial workers. During freak-offs, Combs distributed a variety of controlled substances to in part to keep the obedient and compliant. Sometimes unbeknownst to the Combs kept videos he filmed of engaging in acts with commercial workers. After freak-offs, Combs and the typically received IV fluids to recover from the physical exertion and use.
According to these reports, Diddy kept videos of these encounters and would distribute them as a way of maintaining control. Here's where it gets even crazier. 50 Cent claims that J.Lo wasn't just a bystander. She was allegedly an active participant in these parties. And some of her partners at these freak-offs, 50 alleges, weren't of legal age. He also claims that he's handed over video footage to the authorities, showing J.Lo involved in inappropriate activities with minors. If this is true, it's no wonder Ben Affleck supposedly wanted out before things got any messier. Rumors have been swirling that the real reason behind Ben and J.Lo's rumored divorce has nothing to do with typical celebrity issues, but rather because the FBI allegedly informed Ben about the upcoming indictments and the existence of incriminating footage. This would explain why they've been spotted looking cozy in public, despite filing for divorce. Perhaps it's all a strategy to shield Ben from the fallout.
Only defendant currently, who knows if that increases and it gets superseded with a different indictment. But currently there's only one defendant. My guess is that all of those individuals that could have been co-defendants or could have been co-conspirators or could have been involved in a RICO case have flipped on Sean Combs, and they're getting some sort of immunity.
Now, let's talk about J.Lo's involvement in this case. 50 Cent claims that people in the industry are flipping on Diddy left and right, cutting deals to save themselves. Could J.Lo be one of them? According to insiders, it's highly likely that she's trying to distance herself from Diddy to avoid going down with him. Fans are all over social media, and they're not holding back their opinions. One person commented, J.Lo knew exactly what she was doing. She used Diddy to boost her career, and now she's trying to act like the victim. Shame on her. Another added, of course J.Lo was involved. She's always been about getting to the top, no matter what it takes. She knew what Diddy was up to, and now it's all coming back to haunt her. So, what do you all think? Is Jenny from the block really caught up in this dark scandal? Could 50 Cent's claims be true, or is this just another chapter in his ongoing beef with Diddy? Either way, things are heating up, and it looks like this is just the beginning. Drop your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on the next update in this wild story.